2016 Mazda Miata. You've seen it in pictures. Maybe you've seen it at a show or on a dealer lot. But until you've gotten behind the wheel, you just don't fully understand what this one's all about.
The 2016 MX-5 Miata is offered in three trim levels: Sport, Club, and Grand Touring. We tested a Miata Club in Soul Red with the BBS Brembo option package. The aggressive front splitter and rear lip spoiler provide visual clues to the Club trim level. Mechanical bits include a sport-tuned suspension with Bilstein shocks, a shock tower brace, and a limited slip differential. There's also an induction sound enhancer. The Brembo BBS package includes those big bright red Brembo brakes up front and a set of 17-inch BBS alloys. There are also side sill extensions and a rear bumper skirt.
Not bad. Perhaps the easiest roadster I've ever gotten into. Sometimes they're a little tough. I would say this one is definitely easier than the S2000, a whole lot easier than the Lotus Elise, and compared to the Viper and the Corvette, those are easy to get into. But price-wise, not quite as easy as the Miata is. Headroom at 5'10", I got about three fingers, I'm pretty good. And legroom, plenty. There's a bit of adjustability to the seat if you got shorter legs, you know, if you like to lean back a little bit or lean forward. But I like it all the way back. Seems to fit me well.
While there's no lumbar support, there is thigh angle adjustment for the driver's seat. You'll need to step up to the Grand Touring model for leather upholstery and seat heaters. The steering wheel is small and thin with a minimal amount of padding underneath the stitched leather. Bluetooth, audio, and info screen controls are on the left with cruise controls on the right. The 2-liter Skyactiv 4 puts out 155 horsepower and 148 foot-pounds of torque. Last year's engine put out 167 horsepower and 140 foot-pounds of torque. So the new engine delivers less horsepower, but a bit more torque. The redline is also down a tad from 7,200 to 6,800. The fuel efficiency is dramatically improved. The 2016 Miata is EPA rated at 27 city, 34 highway with the manual transmission. This is a big jump from the outgoing models 2128. So how did they do it? Well, there's that engine, but it's also about curb weight, which has dropped significantly from 2,593 pounds to 2,332, and that's enabled in part by an aluminum hood and trunk lid. It's important to note that 91 octane premium gasoline is recommended, with 87 octane the minimum. Now do yourself a favor and run the correct fuel, which in this case is premium. The bottom line is that this remarkably efficient 2-liter provides all the oomph you'll need to hustle down your favorite set of twisties and deal with highway traffic. Some folks will want more power, no doubt about that, but for most drivers, this powertrain checks all the boxes. The short throw shifter is precise, and the clutch pedal is easy to live with. The soft top is manually operated and it's quick to stow and put up. Just pop the latch, pull it back, and secure with a click. To put it up, flip the release handle, pull off the top, and secure the latch at the top of the windscreen. Super easy.
My big gripe is the infotainment system. While I like the Mazda Connect system overall, the placement of this jog wheel kind of gets in the way of the shifter sometimes, and I find myself changing stations when I don't want to.
There are two USB ports at the base of the dash along with an audio port. You'll find the 12-volt outlet buried deep in the passenger footwell. The 9-speaker Bose audio system includes headrest speakers, which is an important feature for those top-down days.
The other thing I'm not crazy about, the cup holders. Now, I've taken them out because I generally don't use cup holders when I'm driving a sports car. But if you want cup holders, you gotta take them and pop them in here to these wacky little slots, like that. That's suboptimal to me because now it's hit me in the elbow, so I'm really not keen on that either. So my solution is take the things out. Stow them in here. Somebody rides with you that wants to take a drink with them, take them on a really twisty road so they spill it all over themselves. Nah, just kidding. Drink holders are a good thing for many people because you need to have your coffee in the morning. I, however, prefer to take an invigorating drive to work down a twisty road. That's one less cup of coffee. Two things I'd like to see them put into an upcoming version: blind spot mirrors, because there is a significant blind spot back here, and a rear view camera, although that's not as necessary as you might think. If you're driving the Miata with a top down, as you should, you don't need a rear view camera. And even with the top up, this back window is generously sized, you got good vision out the mirrors for backing. It would be nice, and it would be nice to have some sensors back there too. Yeah, it would add a little weight and a little expense, but pretty soon every car is going to have a rear view camera. The Miata will too.
There's a scant 4.59 cubic feet of storage in the trunk, and there's no spare tire, of course, just a puncture repair kit. The competition may be coming, but there's nothing else on the market quite like the MX-5 right now. Sure, the cabin may be tight, the cargo capacity limited, and the ride a bit stiff. But what else can you buy for the money with rear-wheel drive that's so capable and fun to drive? This little critter turns every twisty road into an amusement park ride.